seat for this first try from their own 45. Corey Paws is going deep, trying to catch early, and it is completed. The Tab Perry touchdown, 55 yards. He beats Steve Moore. Tab Perry is a big guy at 6'3", 220, and he can really run. Stephen Moore at corner is 5'9", 172.
And Toledo loves the long ball, and no quarterback in this conference throws it better than Corey Paws. Played that one out there about 60 yards and let Tab Perry cruise underneath and then into the end zone.
Chris Griffith for the extra point try for UCLA. So in the first play from the line of scrimmage, the Bruins put 7 on the board. The kick is good.
Just a week ago, up in Corvallis, UCLA saw the Oregon State Beavers score on the very first play of the game when Steven Jackson went 80 yards.
I think the UCLA football team is growing every week. The Oregon Ducks, they've got Keenan Howry and Sammy Parker. That's Howry in motion. Jason Five looking around, throws, and Parker's all by himself. And, well, it's George Leister, the big tight end, all by himself over there in that corner. And so Oregon comes back with an answer.
Great misdirection by Oregon. They think that wide receiver sweep again, something that allowed Ontario Smith to get some yardage. Here's Reister right here. The sweep comes here. Now Reister's going to sneak down the sidelines, and there's not going to be a Bruin within 10 yards of George Reister. Watch this catch, though. This is really a beautiful catch as he has to reach high above his head, concentrate, get one foot down, and make sure the ball goes inside the pylon.
And here's your extra point try to tie. Jared Siegel, a sophomore out of Sacramento, California, kicking for Oregon. Fife, the quarterback, holds it, and the kick is true. They're going to throw it with John Dubravac, and downfield it is caught, penalty flags, and he's in the end zone. What about it? I think it's a touchdown, because I think Oregon's going to be called for holding, aren't they?
Another trick play by Bob Toledo and the Bruins. This will be a touchdown. Pass interference at the 2-yard line. John Dubravac, 2 for 2 on the year. This is Dubravac here. Paws will move away from center. The ball would be a direct snap to Dubravac.
And he's got to throw it to Craig Gray.
And it's a brilliant play, both in concept and in execution. How about Dubravac? They're going to say, hey, give me a 15 number. I want to play quarterback. And twice, he's hit Craig Bragg for the scores.
Aaron Gibson got there late. And he never caught up, really. He just kind of reaching and grabbing and trying to hold and trying to spoil it any way he could. Here's your extra point try by Chris Griffith. UCLA taking the lead. Second time in a ball game they've had the lead. The kick is up and it is good. Curry, however, to plug that hole. First down, the ball is at, let's put it on the 37-yard line. And Terrence Whitehead is gone. Terrence Whitehead, a freshman from Los Angeles, has just hit pay dirt for the Oregon Ducks. Gosh, that freshman's almost as quick as Smith. He's out of Crenshaw High School here in Los Angeles.
Yeah, big tight end Tim Day is the backup tight end, but he's a great blocker. He's 280 pounds. Here he is right here. Watch him lead the young freshman right up the middle. Gary Campbell, running back coach for the Ducks, says, this is our secret weapon. Terrence Whitehead may not be a secret much longer.
Here's your extra point try by Siegel. Third punt to Dixie, the two previous punts, both 45 yards. Another good one. 22-yard line for Harry, gets a little crack, look out! He's got one man. Cuts back into traffic, though, and it got a little different. And there he goes. It's in the end zone. No flags. Behind it, it's touchdown, Oregon. 79 yards for Keenan Harvey.
He's already. through that first wave, and there's nobody there. There's nobody that has an angle on him. Now he's got a convoy down the field. He can pick up those blocks down there. Jason Willis finishes things off, and Howard's in the end zone.
And the extra point try by Siegel. As Oregon goes to the lead for the first time today, 21-14. We got two wides, we got a slot going in motion. First side. To the sidelines, he's wide open. Defender fell down. It's Craig Bragg. It's a foot race to the corner, and Bragg's going to win it. Touchdown, UCLA. Rasuli Webster fell down, and Bragg went in untouched.
Two plays in a row that Rasuli Webster has fallen down. Might have to go change his sneakers.
At the 71-yard play.
Now Corey Paul's got a pretty good average for completions today. 142 yards on four completions. This is a gift as Rasuli Webster will fall down. Paul puts the ball out in the air, but watch Bragg pull away from Stephen Moore here, number four, trying to close from the right side. Barely coming into the picture and high stepping into the end zone.
The extra point try by Chris Griffith. And we're tied again. And it's Akeel Harris, the single back. You got to figure they're throwing. Corey Paul straight back. Has time. Gets it in the air. Deep. Intercepted. Ball is underthrown and intercepted at the 24-yard line. Second one today for Aaron Gibson. The smallest guy on the field as far as reach is concerned at 5'8". The pass was intended for Ryan Smith, and Smith was out there.
Ball was woefully short and really ill-advised. Look at the coverage by Oregon. One, two, three defensive backs back there, and Gibson is the fortunate one to make the pick. But Corey Paws is just reaching back and firing away regardless of what he sees in the Oregon secondary.
So the Bruins now get possession with a chance. Good field position, and that one is picked off. Stephen Moore, the other corner, gets one.
Oregon doing a great job of changing up their coverages and confusing Corey Paws. He thought that was man-to-man, but Stephen Moore read the quarterback and fell off his coverage and picked off Paws, his third interception of the first half. Watch Moore, just playing his zone there, and at 5'9", plays it like he's 6'9". Man, look at him get up in the air.
Look how much bigger Perry is than he, but it was the smaller man. So it's a 59-yard try. Boom. Low and driving and good. How about that?
Beat the UCLA, offered no rush at all. They just sat there and watched it. He had to drill it low to get it that far. He did exactly that. 59-yard field goal, a new school record for Jared Siegel. Watch the Bruins. They don't move on defense. Nobody's coming in to try to block this. If you block it, you might pick it up and run it in for a touchdown.
It cleared with something to spare, and the Oregon bench exults as they go to the clubhouse, leading 24-21, and here's Todd with Bob Toledo. Paws throws, got some blocking in front of Bragg. Bragg going down the middle of the field, he will score. Bruins go back into the lead.
When you blitz, you got to play man-to-man, and if you're not close on your man, a guy like Craig Bragg will burn you.
All right, Griffith. Blocked it. Nata will get credit for that. So the young man from Salt Lake City making his presence felt in the Rose Bowl.
To get five times.
Throw to. Got to throw it now. And he's got him in. He's open.
field goal. This may come back. It goes to the end zone. Oregon's already lost one touchdown, a 97-yard return.
Holding on the defense.
It's holding on the defense, and it's touchdown, Oregon.
Number 11, Brandon Schiller, the guilty party, as Fife bought time running for his life, keeping his eyes down the field and finding number 15, Keenan Howry. Watch Howry stay alive. And a beautiful toss, and Howry's gone.
Howry's the man that ran the ball back for a touchdown on a punt return as well, remember. So it's a day of big plays at the Rose Bowl. This kick is for the lead. So they're going to put it down on the 36 and makes it a 46-yard try, possibly to win. Hooked it. He hooked it. He missed it.
That's why you want to put the ball in the middle of the field. It's the most difficult of all kicks to kick from a right-footed kicker from the right hash mark.
Yep, you want it on the left one, so you give him some room for that hook.
He can draw it in. Remember, UCLA has no timeouts. They cannot stop the clock. Oregon needs to pick up a first down.
So the defending Pac-10 champions look like they're going to get their second conference win unless they drop the ball or fumble it away or something like that.